All right, there we go. Hi everyone, how's it going? Team here, and this is BxJS coding livestream. We are finally moving to building the actual BxJS website. So it took a while to build the pipeline for BxJS Weekly, but I think now that you know it's ready, we can actually start building the website itself, right? So we had this plan here, and we did the whole search thing and the CI pipeline, so we only need to fetch it and use it in the website itself now I think today we're just gonna make the basic page and wait a second, let me just start the terminal. And we're gonna make the basic page layout, let's put it this way, and we are gonna probably load the index and search using using the index. So let me just increase the font size a bit for you. There we go. All right. Right. So let me go projects, BxJS, BxJS website, right? There we go. And it's probably a good idea. Did I have npm check installed? Yes, I did. Okay, cool. Our modules are up to date, so we're looking good. Here's the question, are they really up to date? Because I remember there was a React Alpha. There was an update to React Alpha, essentially. React, yes, this is what I want to do. As far as I remember, there was like one or two more releases since we scaffolded the website. So I would actually want to update those. Yes, Alpha 2, there we go. Right, git commit. Upgrade React and React DOM versions. There we go. Okay, so we're good with that. Now npm run dev, I think was it? Right, yeah, there we go. Okay, so we can actually what I'm basically planning to do is to do the layout. And once the layout is done, localhost 3000, I think, right? There we go. Yeah, so we got this thing. Right, invalid class in pages index. Did I mess something up here? Yeah, I did mess up. Class name, yeah, is what we want to have, right? Okay, cool. So this should make it work better, and now it all looks nice and. So we're gonna make a nav bar, and I think, you know, because we have essentially everything prepared for the, let me just open the plan over here. So we have everything prepared for our BxJS Weekly section, right? So we might as well start with that. I mean, maybe just first do the nav bar real quick and say, okay, so we have this nav bar item, gonna say href. And we actually want this to be the Next.js link, right? So let me just go to Next.js documentation, because hell if I remember how any of that works. And we're gonna say with the link, import the link and wrap it into a link itself so that, link, go. And in this case, we don't need href over here. So it's gonna be like this, and it's gonna reference the root. And in this case, I'm just gonna say BxJS. We're gonna see about the logo later on. Okay, so we got this thing working, and maybe we can make it bolder, but whatever. So I don't care about design right now, right? So we can talk about this once we get there, essentially, let's put it this way. So we want what? We have info page, which should be the index, right? Which is essentially this one. And I guess we'll just do this. So it's going to be about BxJS. Let's put it this way. We're going to have BxJS weekly, right? So we already have that. So we are going to add the link over here and say, not like this. Link href is going to be weekly. Is, you know, let's keep it basic, right? And finally, we are gonna add, so we got the content, which is the videos, right? And yeah, I guess for now, I'm just gonna add it. It's gonna lead to 404 essentially, right? Content and save, right? So now we got all our pages ready, so navigation should work. Yes, this is gonna lead to 404, which is absolutely what you would expect. We're gonna forget about the about page for now, and we are going to focus on weekly page, right? So weekly JS is what we want to do. I'm going to copy this thing and be like, okay, we got the nav bar, we got the weekly, and gonna save this. And theoretically, if we navigate to weekly right now, we should see the page exactly. And what we want to do here is we want to actually fetch. I'm wondering, like, there's two ways, obviously, right? So we want, first of all, we want to fetch and render the pages, as in the GitHub repository. We want to render the latest issue in place, and then we want to allow looking at the older episodes. Let's put it this way. I don't know if we actually want to render it like in place. Would it make sense? I mean, we're gonna see. And when we need search, and we've done this bit, so I'm just let me do this, and then we're gonna I'm just gonna add those things that are gonna represent basically what we need to do, right? So let's just do it this way. So we did the deduplication and CI pipeline that generates the index. We have two options. We can either load the index actually in the client side in Worker or something, and then search over it there. And I mean, 1.5 meg is quite a lot, but if we cache it properly, then it shouldn't be a major problem. Or we can do it on the server, which would be obviously more efficient. But we're gonna see about that. So first, let's start by, I guess, rendering the stuff from the GitHub, right? So we have our BxJS Weekly repository that contains links to episodes, and we actually want to render the latest one in place and then allow navigating through all the episodes. So let's see, GitHub API, we need the file API, right? So we need the file, the repository, I want to say we need the repository data access, actually. X activity gists, projects, GitHub, the git data. Is that what we want? Introducing git data, yes. Or can I just be like GitHub API file access? Contents API, there we go. This is what we want. So repo owner. Okay, so we need the link to the repo is this stuff, and I guess we can create a component. Let's call it GitHub.js, and const repo link is gonna be HTTP GitHub BxJS. There we go. That's what we want. Right, so we need repos. I wonder if the base URI for it is the same, or do you have to use the different one? Get repos, like, oh, okay, so it should be repos like this, right? Owner, repo, contents, path, repo, readme. Okay, here's the question. So theoretically, if we do this, right, just copy this. So if we query this in the browser, we should get the, nope, that's not correct. Okay, here's the query. I guess the API URI is a different one, right? Okay, so HTTPS API GitHub.com. There we go. That makes more sense. And if we copy this, whoops, let's copy this, right? So we readme, that should return the readme in the JSON format. There we go. Okay, so that's cool. Contents. Now we need the content part, and there was contents path, contents. Okay. And then the path is, in this case, links, right? So I wonder if it will do the, give me the, yeah, there we go. So this is exactly what we want. Okay. So repo link, I guess this is the base, let's call it base URL, right? And then the, we're going to have the API, content access is going to be, so we got this, which means that we need to put in the contents, right? Contents, and then we're gonna have links listing, episodes list, let's call it this way, which is gonna be our base URL, and then it's gonna have content access. I mean, I don't know, do we need that? No, we don't need that much gradation here, right? And it's gonna be links, let's just do it this way. Okay, so we got the episodes, and I'm gonna export const get episodes, and it's gonna be a function that literally just lists the episodes, right? So we're gonna async. Right, and what we want to do is we want to run fetch on episode list. This is going to be a result, await fetch, then our JSON is what we want. So it's going to be our result. And I mean, we could just return it, right? So this is literally all we might want to do, which means that in weekly here, first of all, we need the fetch polyfill because we need the server-side rendering. Fetching the data and lifecycle, yes. What was it? They use some package. I always forget the name of it, but it's like fetch prefetching pages. No. There was like server-side fetch thing. Fetch. No. Prefetching pages. That's also not it. Unfetch. Isomorphic unfetch. There we go. So this is what we're gonna use. NPM install isomorphic. What? No. Come on, we install isomorphic unfetch, and this is what we are gonna use in our GitHub file, right? So we got this isomorphic unfetch, and in this case, we're just gonna say import from. There's gonna be components GitHub, right? And we're gonna import our get episodes thing. So. Yes, I guess we have to convert to class, which is, I really wanted to use functional components, but okay, I guess Next.js is not ready for hooks yet. For default class, weekly extends a React component. Gonna be our render method, right? This. And we need that, what is it called? Get initial props. Method, right? And in this case, res is going to be await. What? Oh, it removed my import. Come on. I need to disable that feature. I enabled it at some point. It was like clean up my imports, and it just starts auto removing things that you imported but don't really use yet. And it might be annoying sometimes, just a tiny bit. There should be episodes, right? And we literally just say episodes. There we go. Okay, and in this case, I'm just gonna do this and do this. No, wait, JSON. But yeah. Oh, thank you very much. JSON stringify this props episodes is what we wanna say, right? And then I'm gonna pretty print it with two spaces. So in theory, if we reload the page, I think I did not start it back yet, right? Run dev. So if we reload the page, we should see the JSON, which is the file listing, right? I would probably reformat it myself a bit because there seemed to be a bit too much data in it. Cool, that works. Okay, so we got the name, we got the path, we got the SHA. I mean, we really only care about the name, URL, and that's actually it, right? So I wonder if we go to this part, this is gonna be what? This is actually gonna be not what we want. So we want HTM, I guess, download URL, is it? I guess we want the download URL, right? Yeah, okay, exactly, cool. So we need to map it, plus all of our files, right? Yeah, so cool. We need to, I guess I would just, what did a class, what did I misspell again? Container, where is it? Class in navbar. Okay. There's a lot of class. Right. I copy pasted a lot of stuff last time and didn't actually recheck it. So that's not good. Okay. Right. So now we need to map the results to actually episode. Right? So we're going to say res map item. And then we're going to map it to an array, which will have. So first of all, we're going to say name. I mean, I could use something like ramdow or lodash to pick the fields, but you know what? We're just gonna roll it lo-fi without any additional dependencies. So we need the download URL. Do we need anything else, actually? I don't think we we want anything else, right? So we literally just want two fields. We want the path and we want the name. Sorry, the download URL and we want the name. I think that should be sufficient for us. And let me just return episodes. There we go. So if we refresh that, we now should see a nice and neat thing. I guess we could actually convert the name. So let's call it file name, and then we're gonna have the name, which is gonna be the episode name, right? And let's call it episode name. Episode name, camel case it to be proper, item name. Right, so we're gonna replace, I already had this regex in the weekly report. Yeah, I had it here, right? We already did that at some point in the tools, so we could just do that here. Let me think. There we go. This is what I did. And exactly what we want. So we want, I guess we need a proper function here. Return this and this. Gonna be item name, right? And we can just do this. Right. Okay. Right. So if I did not screw anything up, we now should see episode name there as well, which also looks fine, but I think we're going to clean it up just a bit more and say that episode name is going to be episode name replace. We're going to replace dash to spacebar, right? Because that is more human readable. There we go. Cool. So this now works. Next thing we want is actually sorting it, right? So we're going to sort AB with, once again, we already done this in the BxJS Weekly. I don't remember where exactly I did it. There we go. Locale compare B. This is exactly what we want to ensure that actually our episodes come in the, are you not liking? A locale compare is not a function. Okay, does node.js? Node.js locale compare. I thought it was like here. I thought it was in the node, actually, to be honest. String. So it supported in pretty much all the browsers. Oh, right, because I'm an idiot and I'm comparing the objects. That should be A file name, right? B file name. There we go. Now that should work, right? There we go. So they are now nicely sorted. And I guess actually in our case, we want it reverse sorted, right? Because people read from like the latest episodes and it's going to be a rare case when they actually want to see the first episodes. So we're going to do that. We got this and... now that we have this list, what we want is render that, right? So we're gonna render that list here. XGS weekly episodes, and then we're just gonna say this props episodes map to episodes, and then data is gonna be. Yes, episode is going to be E, so we just want to do that, right? And now we just need to define this episode.js, right? Okay, and I'm going to import episode from components episodes. There we go. Now we just need to define the component itself. I guess we just the function export defaults. And in this case, we're going to have this episode here, right? Once again, I don't care much about the whole like design thing right now. But we will have to at some point make it look nice. I'll save that. And that doesn't work. Wow. Okay, props episode map E episode. Yeah, so we map it into episode E. So why is there? Where's my episodes? What is happening? Rendering? Wait. That's confusing. Empty divs. Episode name. I am mapping it to episode. Right, that this is the correct spelling. Oh, I guess first of all, we want key. I will use hooks at some point. In this case, we're not using hooks because Next.js and the getInitialProps method is essentially static on class. And Next.js, I don't think they actually have any hooks integration for now, but this is, yeah, lifecycle hooks. But, well, I mean, we're going to use hooks at the other places, essentially. For now, we'll just go roll, you know, we'll just go with this because this is how Next.js works. And I do want that server-side rendering. But don't worry, we'll use hooks at some point. Okay, let me think. We need URL here. So key is going to be URL, right? And why are we not seeing anything? Here's the question. So that should just... Yeah, object or not by, yeah, there you go. That's correct. JSON, stringify. Why are you not? Because there's no name field, of course. I'm an idiot. Episodes. All right. So, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take this and just use it over here because I will forget the format of my data. Right. So we're going to have name is going to be episodes. Episode name, which is redundant, let's be honest about it. So let me just change this to an A. I mean, that makes more sense, right? Because we already have episode. Why do we have episode name for it? There we go. We're gonna have name. We're gonna have that's it actually. We only want a name, right? So that should be a link. But what we want is a link over here. And a link href, and we're going to construct a link from the properties, right? So it's going to be slash episode. Okay, so we would need a we would need a custom server in this case because we would need to handle those sort of links. File name. Yeah, I guess file name would make more sense because we would have to filter by it from the GitHub again. Link, and then we have a here. And like this, I guess. Yeah, right. Completely broken. That is not what we want. Okay, kinda getting there. Okay, now let's go to Bulma and see what kind of lists can we use to make it look slightly nicer. Station, come on. Layout form elements components. Think layout is probably not probably like elements or components, right? Why are you being so slow? Right, button box. No, that's not what we want. Components, breadcrumb, drop down, menu, menu maybe. Nav bar panel hard on that. Here, wait a second. Here's the question. Can we get some more? We don't need that anymore. We actually got all the data we need from the API. What I'm curious about is if I go to the API and say contents links, we actually get a date from it. We get a size, right? So yeah, I mean, we can kind of parse the date from here because this is the year and this is the week, but whatever. I mean, I would want a date. We get a date. I guess we have to convert the months and week to a proper date because otherwise that would not be nice. But we can do it later. Okay, fine. For now, it's okay. Menu, okay, no, that's not. Drop down, form layout, columns. I guess we can just be like, can we just make a list, box content, idle table. Yeah, I guess we can just make a list, right? It can be, let me think for a second. So we can just do a div. Have you used React Habitat with a CMS? I never heard about React Habitat before, to be honest. So let me just have a look. What is that? Habitat. What the hell is React Habitat? React DOM Bootstrapper designed to harmonize a hybrid CMS plus React. That is completely new area to me because I always built my own backend solution. So that looks, I don't know. I would need like a few, a couple of an hour or so to actually figure out what that thing does, because it's like literally first time seeing that. Okay, so we got episodes here. This stuff, you know what we can do? We can make it slightly prettier and we can actually wrap it into cards. That should work nicely. So we got components, we got cards, and div class cards. So we're gonna say class name in this case. And it's gonna be class content, I guess. Want content. First of all, let's just save it like this and see how that looks. That looks absolutely terrible. Right, let's not just go into design for now. Let's leave it at this. Right, and once we click it, yes, this is going to go to 404 because right now we need a server. And we also actually want to pass some payload with that link. Where is my link thing? So we need to pass a payload, and it should be, I remember there was a way to pass the payload with it. We could probably, that still is an ugly solution. Footer push dynamic. I want to minimize the number of requests, but pushing the payload is one thing. Fetch dynamic. Like what I want to do is essentially when the user clicks on the link from here is to already pass the download URL, right? Because we already know it. And when it comes from the server side, it basically would mean that the user would have to, or the server would have to reload that, but is the link ref link prefetch? There should be a docs for the, no, that's the prefetch stuff, right? Should be a documentation for the links. Let me think for a second. With the link, with URL, there we go. Get the prefetch, we got the path query, node.js URL model documentation. That is still not what we want, right? So we got the href query, this is not what we want. Am I just imagining things? Am I confusing the React router with it? That might be the case. I guess, yeah, why not? Let's just do it on the server side, because why the hell not? Okay, but we do need our custom server in this case. Because I don't remember that Next.js, I don't think they actually shipped the custom routing yet. Okay, so we got the links, we got imperatively, we got pop state. Yeah, okay. So we need the custom server, and I think I'm just gonna go with Express, because why not? First of all, it actually could be a good idea to commit what we've added now. Add basic BxJS weekly episodes page and episodes fetching, right? We do that. Whoops, I mistyped that. Right, we did that, and now what we need to do is we need to add the server, right? I'm just gonna take this, copy it from here, be like, okay, now we have the server.js, and it is literally just gonna be npm install. I wonder if we should just go with Fastify, because I feel like, if we're using Express, we're gonna need like additional packages for handling the, payloads and everything, so maybe we'll just go with Fastify, because I do like Fastify and it's a very nice framework. Right, so we need npm install Fastify, right? And I'm gonna refactor this thing just a tiny bit. So you're gonna be async and you're gonna be awaited over here, because this is gonna remove one whole level of nesting. And yes, we are not gonna catch any errors now, because there should be none. We're doing dev this. We do not need, so we handle request, handle 404. And in this case, we are gonna have episode. What was the URL that I've used? It was like slash one. This is what we want, right? And in this case, this part is gonna be file. So request reply. This is gonna be handled by episode, and this is gonna be query, and it's gonna be file. It's gonna be request params file. Right. This is what we want. And I guess we could also rewrite this to be. I guess making it async would make it a bit less nested because I like this nesting. Apologies. This nesting is a bit hard to digest. Let's just rewrite it real quick. I do like my async await. Right. I don't know. Can I actually? No, I guess we actually cannot do the await thing, right? Okay. We cannot do that because you have to return something, I think. So, or maybe not. Okay, let's try. I wonder if that should work, I think, right? It doesn't really care about the returns as much. Think handler here, await that. And then reply sent and are done. Okay, festival listen, yes, this looks fine. So I think we need to edit our package JSON now because we no longer will invoke next, but we rather will call our server, right? So we're gonna say dev is this and production is this. Okay, in theory, if I didn't screw anything up, npm run dev, we should be able to see our website right now. And yeah, this is 404. This is fine. Website, does it work? It does work. And we go to weekly, that also loads. And now why is this 404? Because that should work, right? So I got the episode and then I got the slug of file. Oh, because I did not create an episode page, right? Yes, there we go. And I'm just going to copy this and we can close this. We don't need this anymore for now. We don't need this. We need this. We'll leave the server for now. So it's going to be episode here. We are going to have to do prefetching, right? So this episode render. And in this case, we're just going to leave this empty for now. Just realized you're a guy with building products with JavaScript video series. Yes, exactly. This is, BxJS is exactly what it means. All right, so we got the episode rendering. And now we got the episodes, but we also need to get the file slug, right? So we should have, wait a second. What was the name of it? Get initial props. So we want the request, or we actually want not the request, but we want the request. We want the query, I think, right? And console log query, right? That should be logged here, right? So we got the file slug, exactly. So we got the episodes, which means that we find our current episode in them. Current episode is gonna be episodes filter. I guess find would be a better option here. There's gonna be app, and we are gonna find an episode so that file name, right? File name equals query file. And we are gonna return current episode as well, right? So in theory, let me just this div this props current. I guess you know what? Let's just do it this way. So stringify this props. There we go. The reloads. Okay, we got the episodes and we got the current episode. Where is the current episode? Yeah, that is a bit too much. This props current episode. Right, we got the episode, so we got the URL here. And we need to now actually fetch that URL, right? So let's call it const episode content is gonna be await fetch current episode's URL, right? And then we're gonna say then r, but in this case we don't want JSON, we actually want plain text, right? And we're gonna say current episode's content equals episode content, right? So this should fetch our markdown and append it to the episode object exactly, and now we have this. Looks nice. So now we want a markdown renderer. Let me think. So Node.js markdown. I mean, yeah, there's the markdown it. GitHub, no, JavaScript markdown parser. I remember there was this new markdown parser that was supposed to be really fast. Oh yeah, was it this one? I just moved the window accidentally. No, that's too far. There we go. Snarkdown, 1 kilobyte parser written in JavaScript. That seems, I mean, it is from Mr. Developit, who is behind the Preact and other super fast, super tiny libraries. So I think this is a safe bet, right? So we're gonna go with it. Seems simple enough because we don't really need that much features from it. Whoops. Why am I pressing those buttons? Right, so we're gonna do this. We're gonna import this Snarkdown, and we literally just want to render the received thing, right? Contents, call it Markdown, and then we can say current episodes content HTML. So I'm just basically gonna pre-render it on a server, right? If it's requested from the server side. Markdown content, yes. And what we need to do now is we just need to say, hell if I remember how it's done, React HTML. I always forget the dangerously set. No, that's Chinese. Why does it show me Chinese documentation? There we go. So we want this dangerously set HTML. And then I remember it was like underscore HTML. Yes. And it's going to be this props. You know what, let's just use some destruction because this is getting a bit out of hand. Content HTML is gonna be this props current episode. Yes, want content HTML, right? I think that should render it nicely. I forgot to start it, of course, npm run dev. Right, I think that should actually render our episodes, and we do need a button back to all episodes there, probably, or maybe not. Right, there we go, almost, kind of almost there. The thing is, what we want is to actually wrap it into class name content, I believe, right? Because Bulma doesn't have styles by default. There we go. This looks nice and cozy. That is a bit too much zoom. So we actually have all the things that we need to add, some padding and styling and everything. We probably should change the title to actual, right. Current episode is gonna be this props. Gonna be distracted from current episode, and we also need the name, right? So this is gonna be actually name, and I guess we can just say BxJS Weekly, and then the name, right? So we now have episode 38, perfect. Maybe like this, that looks even nicer. Cool. So we actually have the episodes, and all the links should be clickable and working. Yeah, that seems to be working nicely. Neat. Now we got this episode here. Let's just check that all of them work as expected. That is quite nice. That is slightly different formatting to what I wanted, but that's an old episode, doesn't count. Cool. We actually have the rendering working. quite nicely. So we got this working. Let me think. What do we have here? We got archive working. Here's the question. Do I want to render the current page? Like when you... Do you guys, when you click on the weekly episodes, do you expect to see the latest episode here and then see the archive on the side or something? Or do you want to actually navigate to the latest episode? I guess it makes more sense to just render the latest episode in here and then have a sidebar with the rest of the episodes, right? At least I think to me that would make more sense. So we want navbar, I guess. Right, so here's what I'm gonna do. So we don't need a server anymore. I'm gonna, let me think. So we are, I basically want that, right? But that's gonna be duplication. I don't want duplication, I wanna copy code. Not terrible to copy paste that, but is there a nicer solution to that? The get initial props, if I remember correctly, next only works on the page itself. So we cannot actually abstract that into component, which is a bit annoying. Let me think. Yeah, I mean, maybe copy pasting is not too terrible. Let's just go with it. Why not? Let's see. I mean, maybe I'll come up with a better solution at some point, but for now, let's just do it this way. We got this, but instead of doing that, instead of finding the episodes, we're just gonna pick the first one, right? Current episode, so we're gonna fetch it, we're gonna render it, and in this case, we're gonna say, right, so here's the title. Once again, the rendering is gonna be quite similar to what we have now, except we're gonna have the episodes. Maybe I just should do. Okay, you know what? I'm not gonna think too much about that right now. I'm just gonna do it like this, and then we're gonna figure it out later if there's a better way. So I feel like there should be a better way. But at that, we gonna copy this bit. There is a significant amount of duplication here, but right, so we got the contents, and essentially this would render the latest episode, right? Yep. And then we're gonna have the list of episodes on the bottom. So what I would want to do is I would want to actually wrap this into I want to wrap it into actually the two column layout, right? And basic, yeah, so we want columns, right? Class name columns, and we want a div class. I mean, maybe again, columns is not the best way here, but whatever, we again can decide on the design later on. Come on, nope, column is what I want to say. And we want to render our episodes as sort of a sidebar, right? Okay, so, but we want to sort of shift it. So we want to resize, we want to make the second column small, basic sizes. There we go. Can I, yes, is 4/5. My guess is 4/5 should work, maybe. Column new, there we go. Yes, thank you very much. I just noticed it thanks to the auto suggestions, and I tend to do those a lot. All right, yeah, that looks decent. So I guess we could just say H2 episodes list, right? So like this. And yeah, column content, probably content. I guess we could also just say, I mean, can we just do this? Maybe I don't even need that additional nested div. That work? Yeah, that does. Cool. Right, so we now have this. It's the cool thing is that all of that is going to be rendered either in the client if you click on any of those links, right? Or it's going to be rendered on the server when you refresh the page, right? So the client actually doesn't do any heavy lifting. And there is no additional requests, which is kind of great. some pop-ups coming from the content scripts, but that's like my my additional things. So the file, the page itself has 28 megs with all the debug info, but I guess if we build it, it's going to be way smaller. Episodes lists, I guess we should remove, now that I'm thinking about it, yeah, I think, you know what we're going to do? We are going to change that a bit. So because, again, we don't need that code duplication. And what we are going to do here is I'm going to kill this episode thing. Right. So we don't want this query bit. Right. I think this is going to work quite nicely. So we're going to have this episode bit and we're gonna copy this stuff. And then we're going to say, so if otherwise, no, not like this. It should be otherwise episode. So just bear with me for a second. So if query file is there, we're going to search for that episode with a query file. And if it's not there, we're just going to take the top episode, right? And then in episodes, I am going to filter out the current episode. So that episodes URL not equal current episode URL, right? So we're not going to show the current episode in the sidebar, which means we can kill the episodes thing, which means there's less code duplication. But we also have to adjust the server to render it to weekly. There we go. I guess we could actually change it to weekly and then file name, right? Where did I do this links? I think it was the in the episode weekly. Okay. So if we restart our server, then now, first of all, we just remove the code duplication, which is always nice. Second of all, we should have a nice sidebar which lists the episodes that are everything aside from the currently selected one. Or maybe rendering it is still a good idea, but just highlight it somehow. Yeah, I think we're not going to filter it, but rather we are going to say current, and it's going to be current episode, and we're just gonna be like, okay, if episodes, and then we're gonna have current episodes. So if okay, you know what, I'm gonna just do this style JS6, right? And we're gonna have a conditional style here, last name gonna be episode. Have the episode style, save it, and it's gonna be font weight. This is not what I want. Font weight, there we go. And in this case, we're gonna be like, okay, so if the episodes, and our type apparently equals current episode URL. I mean, there's obviously is better way of doing it, but for now, inherit is what I'm gonna do. So in theory, there we go. So now bold selected, right? And if we click on this, cool. So we got rid of the duplication and this now I have a nice tree of episodes and we click all of them and this is broken. Res map is not a function. What? Okay, that is curious. How come? So if I refresh it, it still is broken. 18 episode 21, okay. Nah. All right, we already caught a bug. And I guess this is from the GitHub JS, right? GitHub JS line 10 res is not a function. That is interesting. Bug res. Is there like a limit or something? I guess we want to try catch, right? Error E. And I'm just gonna return the empty list for now. Res map. What is the? Is there any error there? Res map is not a function. But, what is happening? No, it's JSON. Okay, so I guess it's still it returns the JSON. Is that like GitLab down or something? What is happening? API rate, oh, okay. So there is a rate limit. Okay, that makes it a bit more annoying. I guess we have to cache it somehow, which means that we need to move that GitHub querying to our own server, right? Because it already runs in the backend. And right, so we need this and this and this and this. How do we do this? So we need to move it to our own server and then cache the response for 24 hours or something. I mean, actually BxJS Weekly updates like every 7 days, right? So we can cache it for like 6. Should be sufficient, I think. But okay, I mean, for now that doesn't really matter. So we hit the... I think we did basically everything I wanted to do in the current stream. So we got the current episode, we got the archive. And the next time we can start working on the search using the, and I actually should write down, so we, editor, we did that. We need search and we need handle GitHub API limit. Right, because we're gonna hit that limit very fast if people come and query the pages, right? We actually need server cache, responses on our server, right? So we just need to cache the response in our server and that will take like 20 more minutes of work. We're not going to do that today. And I guess first handle that limit and then do the search. We got the search nearly ready. Once again, we already have the index, the pre-generated index.js and weekly now in releases, right? So we go in the weekly, in the releases, we got our index.json here, which our server should download and then use Elastic Lunar to load that index in memory and expose some sort of API endpoint over which we will actually search, right? But yeah, I think that is gonna be it for today's live stream. So I am gonna commit that. Let me see, what did we do? We added the rendering for the episodes, right? Yeah, that. Lot of package.json stuff. Yeah, let's add BxJS weekly episodes list and rendering. There we go. Okay, sign the commits and we are good. Okay, so if you guys have any questions over what you've seen so far, feel free to throw them now into the chat. If not, then we might as well wrap this up and continue next week on Monday, I guess. Yes, I am using Next.js as the framework because it is literally the easiest way, in my opinion, to do anything React-related. Pointers for using Next.js. Well, I mean, first of all, their documentation is quite good. Second of all, if you you can find my Next.js introduction video on the YouTube channel. So I did a tutorial quite some time ago, and I think it's still more or less valid. But like... yeah, first of all, their documentation. Second of all, if you have any problems, they have absolutely incredible examples folder that has examples for just about anything you can imagine. There's like hundreds of examples here, which is awesome. But yeah, it's a really, really great framework and the docs are really good. I mean, it all comes down to actually React. So there's like the most problems you might have with it are related to how it renders stuff on server side. So this is like the quirkiest bit of it, let's put it this way. But in general, it's a really cool framework. And once again, you know, it just literally allows you to do server side render things in milliseconds, essentially, because you don't even have to think about that. Okay, any more questions or anything you guys want to ask about? I am open to just about anything you want to talk about. If not, then yes, let's just wrap it up and continue on Monday. I think, let me just do it this way, preview. So I think, okay, preview doesn't have checkbox rendering, but we actually should have it here, right? There we go. Okay, so we almost finished with the weekly news bit. So we just need the API limit handling and then search. And we're done with that. And after that, we'll do the info page, which is probably the easiest one. And the trickiest one would be the videos collection. So it should be the collection of all the videos and stuff like this. Do you have a favorite UI framework for React? I'm using Bulma here, and this is my favorite go-to CSS framework. Primarily because it doesn't have any JavaScript attached to it. It works really well with React. Because of that, so like, you know, you have the models, but they don't have any JavaScript. So you have to actually do everything yourself. But the models themselves work really well. So this works really well with React. Majority of time, I don't like the whole, like, you know, all-in-one packages that is like the React semantic UI, React Bootstrap or whatever, because they are really hard to customize, is what I want to say. But, you know, maybe it works for you. So if it works for you, then it's just fine. So I don't think any of them are, you know, like a bad or specifically terrible or anything. I just prefer the very simplistic approach, let's put it this way. If it works for you, just go with it. Like, there's nothing wrong about that. Okay. Cool. Any other questions? Or if not, we can just wrap it up here. I pushed everything. It's, let me just make sure real quick. Terminal. ESL. Yes, I did. Okay, cool. We're good. Right. Doesn't seem like there's any more questions. So thank you much for what am I even saying? Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your continued support. And we are going to continue coding next week on Monday. So stay tuned. And there's, as always, going to be BxJS Weekly JavaScript News Podcast tomorrow. So if you're interested in that kind of stuff, jump around tomorrow and see what we're going to be talking about. There is quite a lot of pretty terrible news, let's put it this way. But they are quite interesting to talk about. So there we go. All right. Thank you guys for watching. Have an awesome rest of the day, and I see you next time. Bye.